winter and part of the summer too. All the harm that I have done was to court a pretty fair maid. One night she came to my bedside, bitterly she did weep. Come to my bed, my pretty fair maid, get out of the foggy dew. She laid in my arms till broad daylight, the sun began to shine. I turned my back on the pretty fair maid, goodbye my love, I'm gone. Toward the first part of the year, she took pale in the face. Along toward the latter part of the year, she got bigger around the waist. Along toward the last of the year, she brought me a son. Now you see as well as I what the foggy dew has done. I've taken this girl and I married her, I loved her as my life. I've taken this girl and I married her, she made me a virtuous wife. I never throwed it up to her, and damn my eyes if I do. For every time the baby cried, I'd think of the foggy dew. Stuck on a Danville girl. Boys, that kid was out of sight. She wore them Danville curls. Fur and waist so stylish, she trailed the fashion too. Whenever that mountain train goes by, I'm gonna bid that girl adieu. I don't know why I loved her, she never cared for me. But oh, my heart was the one to live wherever she may be. Mother told me long ago in the days when I was young, says, dear boy, you better watch out because a day like this will come. I walked up to the conductor, I give him a line of talk. He says, I'll take your money, boy, and I'll see that you don't walk. But when he found that I was broke, he turned around and cried, you'll have to get off of this railroad train, you cannot bum your ride. I hung all around the water tank until the next freight train come by. It comes screaming around the bend, I caught her on the fly. The engine screamed and the whistle blew and the bells begun to ring. I swung on to that old boxcar and I bummed that railroad train. Well, now I'm in your city, boys, and I'm trying to do what's right. Don't think because I'm a railroad bum that I'm not all right. Just give me a job and I'll settle down and I'll work with all my might. I sure be on the job every day and I won't ramble out at night. That girl I left in Danville, that girl like broke my heart. That girl I left in Danville, from her I had to part. If ever I play another hand, I hope that I will win. But I don't want to ever see that Danville girl again. The wind blows cold, moan true love, and a few cold drops of rain. I never had but one true love, in the cold grave she was lain. I'll do as much for my true love as any young man may. I'll set and mourn by her graveside for a 12-month and a day. The 12-month and a day being up, the dead begins to speak. Who is it sits by my graveside and will not let me sleep? It's I, my love, sits by your grave and will not let you sleep. I crave one kiss from your cold clay lips and that's all I seek. You crave one kiss from my cold clay lips, but the call of death is strong. If you get one kiss from my cold clay lips, your time it won't be long. 'Tis down in yonder garden path, love, where we used to walk. The finest flower that ever grew is withered on. stalk. Beau Lambkins was as fine a mason as ever laid stone. He built a fine castle, and pay he got none. Said the landlord to the lady, when I'm from home, beware of Beau Lambkin, should he catch you alone. Oh no, said the lady, you need not fear him. Our doors are all bolted and our windows barred in. Beau Lambkins rode by when the landlord was away, and seeing a false nurse at a window did say, oh, where is the landlord, or is he at home? He's gone to merry England for to visit his son. And how shall I enter, said Lambkins to her. The false nurse then arose and unbolted the door. If the lady is upstairs, how shall we get her down? We'll stick her little baby full of needles and pins. Beau Lambkins rocked hard, and the false nurse she sung, while the tears and red blood from the cradle did run. The lady come downstairs, not thinking of harm. Beau Lambkins then arose and caught her in his arms. Oh, spare me, Beau Lambkins, oh, spare me a day, and you shall have as much gold as your horse can take away. Oh, spare me, Beau Lambkins, oh, spare me a while. Can't you hear how mournful my little baby does cry? Oh, spare me, Beau Lambkins, oh, spare me an hour, and you shall have my daughter Betsy, my own blooming flower. You can keep your daughter Betsy to wade in the flood. Here, hold the silver basin to catch your heart's blood. Oh, stay, daughter Betsy, in your chamber so high, till you hear your dear father as he comes riding by. Oh, father, said Betsy, when the landlord come home, Beau Lambkins killed my mother while you was gone. Beau Lambkins was hanged to the gallows so high, while the false nurse was burned to a stake standing by. Down in Adairsville I did dwell, a farmer's boy I loved so well. He courted me my life away, he's with me now, but he will not stay. There is another house in this same town, my love goes there and sets him down. He takes another girl all on his knee, and he tells to her that he once told me. Oh grief, I'll tell you why. Because she has more gold than I. Her gold will rust and her beauty will fade, and she, like me, will die an old maid. Must I go bound and he go free? Must I love a boy who don't love me? Oh no, that'll never be, till oranges grow on an apple tree. Go dig my grave both wide and deep, put a marble slab at my head and feet, and on my breast there'll come a dove to show the world that I died of love.
Up in Cornwall, all in a high degree. My parents, they adored me, had child, only me. I ripped, I roved, I rambled where'er my fancies led, till I become a prentice, and then my joys they fled. The man that I was bound to, he did not use me well. I formed a resolution with whom not long to dwell. Unbeknown to my poor parents, from him I ran away. I steered my course to London, and cursed be the day. There were a lady in London, she chanced to spy me there. She offered me great payments to dwell with her 1 year. With her kind words and promises, with her I did agree to go with her to London and stay with her 1 year. I hadn't been in London but 6 months and a day when my foolish mistress grew very fond of me. Her gold and silver, her houses and her land, if I'd consent to marry her, would be at my command. Oh no, my honored mistress, I cannot marry you, for I have made a promise, likewise a solemn vow, to wed no one but Betsy, my beauteous honored maid. Pray excuse me, honored mistress, she has my heart betrayed. One morning as I walked out to take the pleasant air, my mistress followed after me to view the lilies fair. Gold rings from off her fingers as she did pass me by, she slipped them in my pocket, and for them I must die. The sheriff come and taken me, it was useless to say. He took me up to justice, tried me before the mayor. He took me up to justice and to the gallows tree. Oh Lord, reward my mistress, she surely has wronged me. The people all come flocking in to see me in my life. Likewise, fair pretty Betsy, my own intended wife. Farewell to sin and sorrow, I'll bid you all adieu. Likewise, fair pretty Betsy, I'll die for loving you.
Sets
house in yon hill, and I hope that'll never be. They rested me and they taken me back. I got up early next morning, put on my boots. I got up early next morning, put on my boots. Said they sent me down to Frankfurt to wear the striped suit.
Was a lady in New York, all along little Omi. She fell in love with her father's clerk, all down by the Greenwood Society. As she was going over the bridge, all along little Omi, she found herself a growing big, all down by the Greenwood Society. She leaned her back against an oak, all along little Omi. First it bent and then it broke, all down by the Greenwood Society. She leaned herself against a thorn, all along little Omi. There she had two little babes born, all down by the Greenwood Society. She carried a penknife both keen and sharp, all along little Omi. She pierced those little babes to the heart, all down by the Greenwood Society. She buried them under a bunch of rue, all along little Omi. She prayed to the Lord they'd never come to, all down by the Greenwood Society. As she was walking across the porch, all along little Omi, she saw two little babes at play, all down by the Greenwood Society. Oh, babes, if you were mine, all along little Omi, I'd dress you up in silk so fine, all down by the Greenwood Society. Mother, oh mother, when we were thine, all along little Omi, you neither dressed us coarse nor fine, all down by the Greenwood Society.
Mother, oh mother, for our sakes, all along little Omi, you'll always carry the key to Hell's Gate, all down by the Greenwood Siding. Going to her bed, she heard the sound of a musical horn, which made her heart feel glad and sad to think it was her brother John, John coming in from his wild hunt. But who should it be but her love Henry, returning from his king, king, returning from his king. Light down, love Henry, and stay all night with me. You shall have the cheer of a cheer, cold girl, the best I can give thee, the best I can give thee. I won't lie down, I shan't lie down, and stay all night with thee. There's a pretty girl in Mary Greenlee I love far better than thee, I love far better than thee. He bended over her soft pillow and gave her a kiss so sweet. With a penknife in her right hand, she wounded him in full deep, deep. She wounded him in full deep. Woe be, Lady Margaret, he cried. Woe be to thee. Can't you see my own heart's blood come twinkling down my knee, knee, come twinkling down my knee. She called unto a maid of hers, keep a secret on me. All these fine robes on my body will always be to thee, will always be to thee. One taking him by his long yeller hair, the other one by his feet. They threw him into the well waters, which was so cold and deep, deep, which was so cold and deep. Lie there, love Henry, till the flesh rots off your bone. And that pretty girl in Mary Greenlee thinks long of you coming home, home, thinks long of you coming home. Up spoke, a pretty little parrot exceeding on a willow tree. There never was a girl in Mary Greenlee he loved far better than thee, he loved far better than thee. Come down, my pretty little parrot, and set all on my knee. You shall have the cage of a pure, pure gold instead of the willow tree, tree, instead of the willow tree. I won't come down, I shan't come down, and set all on your knee. You've murdered your love, Henry, more sooner you would kill me, me, more sooner you would kill me. If I had an arrow in my hand, my bow on a tuneful string, I'd shoot a dart that would win your heart so you could no longer sing, sing, you could no longer sing. If you had an arrow in your hand, your bow on a tuneful string, I'd spread my wings and fly away and tune my voice to sing, sing, and tune my voice to sing. To me, my name is nothing extra, and that to you I'll tell. To all you Texan Rangers, I'm sure I wish you well. When at the age of 16 I joined the Jolly Band, we marched to Western Texas into the rebel land. My captain, he gave orders, perhaps he thought 'twas right. Before you reach yon mountains, my boys, you'll have to fight. I saw the smoke arising, the bullets round me hailed. My feelings at that moment no human tongue can tell. I saw the rebels coming, I heard them give a yell. My spirit sank within me, my courage almost failed. We fought for 9 long hours before the fight was o'er. The like of dead and wounded I never saw before. I thought of my old mother, whom often I'd heard say to you, they all are strangers at home, you'd better stay. I thought her old and foolish, and that she did not know my heart was bent on roving, and I was bound to go. Perhaps you have a mother, likewise a sister too. Perhaps you have a sweetheart who'll weep and mourn for you. If this be your condition, I'm sure you should not roam. I'll tell you by experience, you'd better stay at home. Rode home so fine. George Collins rode home one cold winter night and taken sick and died. Little Mattie was sitting in George's room, sewing her silk so fine. And when she heard that George was dead, she laid her silks aside. She followed him up, she followed him down, she followed him to the grave. She fell upon her bending knees, she wept, she mourned, she prayed. Set down the coffin, lift up the lid, set back the sheeting so fine, and let me kiss those sweet cold lips, for I know they'll never kiss mine. Oh daughter, don't weep and cry, there's other young men besides George. Oh mother, George has my heart, and now he's dead and gone. Oh, don't you see that lonesome dove flying from pine to pine? It's mourning for its own true love, just like I'll mourn for mine. Look up, look down that long, lonesome road, hang down your head and cry. The best of friends must part sometime, and so must George and I.